In this video, we're going to answer the question, can you put a ferrule crimp or bootlace crimp or a wire end sleeve onto a class 2 stranded conductor? This question relates to a couple of videos that we've made recently, one on an awesome swivel head crimper from Weehar and another that discusses the different categories or classes of conductors. So do please go and check those out as they'll aid your understanding of this video. Now, if there's one thing we've learned while working on eFIXX, it's that electricians love a crimp. And indeed, they are marvellous things that can help to create stronger connections. However, there has been some questions raised regarding the proper use of ferrule crimps, in particular when it comes to using them on class 2 conductors. Now, just as a quick reminder, that's a conductor that has large individual strands, for example, like a 6mm twin and CPC cable for a cooker. So could you put a ferrule crimp on this type of conductor? Well, first of all, it's worth knowing that this type of crimp was originally developed in Germany for class 5 wiring in control panels as a quick alternative to soldering. And it's there to prevent stray whiskers from causing shorts and reducing the current carrying capacity of a conductor. And so we actually need to dive into a German standard rather than a British standard for more information, namely DIN 46228-4. Now, my German is not all it should be, and so I've relied on Google Translate to help me with this. In section 7 we read, Sieben. Anforderungen aller Hülsen nach dieser Norm müssen zu beschaffen sein. Das Kupferleiter der Klasse 2, Klasse 5 und Klasse 6 nach DINAN 60228 ordnungsgemäß im Hülsenbereich L2 umfasst werden. So I think that's pretty clear. However, due to my very badly mangled German, the significance of that may have passed you by, so it translates roughly as, wire end sleeves according to this standard must be designed in such a way that copper conductors of class 2, class 5 and class 6, according to DIN EN 60228, are properly included in the sleeve area L2. So in other words, ferrules need to fit onto the ends of class 2, class 5 and class 6 conductors. However, when you dig a little deeper into that standard, it points out that there is no standardisation of the crimping tools and therefore the testing of the crimped sleeves to comply with the standard is optional and can be carried out by the manufacturer. It then outlines what this test should consist of, but in that outline it only mentions the use of class 5 conductors, which are what we usually think of as a conductor in a flexible cable. So what this means is that while the crimps are made to accommodate class 2, 5 and 6 conductors, the testing procedure outlined only checks they are working with class 5 conductors. For this reason, some manufacturers of crimps will state that they should only be used with class 5 conductors and that any deviation from this will need evaluation. If you refer back to our video on classes of conductors, you'll see that as cable sizes increase, the difference in diameter between class 2 and other classes of conductors becomes considerable. So much so that the trusty pull test of a ferrule results in ferrules simply slipping off the larger conductors when crimped. Interestingly, some crimp manufacturers will also state that their crimps should only be used with their crimpers, as that's what they've been tested with. Of course, we do also need to bear in mind that this is a German standard, not an IEC or a British standard, so the experts who wrote it won't have been considering any of the usual wiring practices that we use in the UK. If you were to mention to them twin and earth or even the use of class 2 conductors in a fixed installation, you'll get some funny looks over there. So there we go. The short answer is, if you want to use your ferrule crimps on anything apart from a class 5 conductor, you should seek advice from the manufacturer of the crimp. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you love a ferrule crimp? Do you use them on class 2 conductors? Or do you think that that does more harm than good? Whatever your thoughts, whatever your questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.